What's up, GSM? It's Wednesday night. We're super pumped that you're with us. It's Brennan and Kevin, and we're joining you as hosting. We're super excited. Kevin, are you pumped?
Oh, I'm so pumped. You can tell that I'm hanging out with Jimmy Fallon here at the studio.
Yeah, it looks like you're in studio. That is amazing. How did you also show your – what are you wearing right now?
You know, it's April, but I'm wearing my Christmas sweater because, honestly, I don't even remember what day it is. And so – And I feel like the outside doesn't even know what season it is.
It's right. We had snow yesterday or whatever it was. We could have snow a couple days.
Who knows? Who knows?
Hey, I've heard stories of people who still have their Christmas tree and decorations up. They haven't taken them down.
Yeah. Why?
Why not?
No, might as well enjoy them.
Exactly.
Yeah. Well, Brennan, you've been with us for over a month, but I feel like I really haven't done my duty of maybe like hazing the new guy.
Yeah.
So I thought we would maybe like play a little game.
Okay.
So basically how this game is going to work is it's going to be kind of like charades. So you're going to mute your sound here in a second so you can't hear a thing that I'm saying.
Okay.
And then I will give you like phrases or words. I'll tell you how many words are in it by how many fingers I'm holding up. And then if you get it right, I'll give you a thumbs up.
Okay.
But I think just for the sake of making sure that you are kind of in the Grable culture and making sure you're understanding, I'm going to pick like five words that have to do with people, events, common language at Grable and see if you can get them in 60 seconds.
60 seconds. Okay.
So
okay.
Wow. Five words in 60 seconds.
Okay.
Do you think you can do this?
I think we can do it. Yeah. Okay. We can try it. We'll give it a shot.
Okay. So when you're ready, make sure you can't hear me.
Can I hear anything you're saying? I am muted.
All right, here we go.
Two words.
GSM now. GSM now.
Cheese and crackers?
GSM now.
GSM. GSM now. GSM
yes.
now.
Yes, GSM yes, now. Yes, yes.
Got it.
Nancy Souter. Nancy.
Two words. Souter.
Nancy
Souter.
Yes.
I got that one easy. Yes, that was easy. Nancy. One.
CDYC. CDYC. CDYC.
DYC. CYC.
Yes.
CYC.
Yes.
Of course.
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yes.
Okay. Halfway there. Two words.
All in. All in.
All in. All in.
Yes.
Oh, yeah.
Two words. Common grounds. Common grounds.
Common grounds. Common
yes!
grounds. Common grounds.
Woo!
Is that all of them?
Yes. Yes.
That is amazing.
Are you kidding me?
Boom.
The
Look at
that.
Newbie
has skills. Let's go.
Easy. Hey, actually, I got one for you. I've just got one for you. So you got to mute yourself.
Okay. All right.
Okay. I got one. Can you hear me?
I can't hear you.
You can't hear me. Okay. All right. Ready? I got one. One word.
One word.
Birthday.
Burlingame.
No, can't get it.
I don't got it. One more time. One more time.
Birth. Birthday. Birthday.
Birth.
Day. Day.
Birthday.
Birthday. Because guess what, GSM? While you're watching this video, tomorrow is Kevin's birthday.
What?
So we're going to sing happy birthday all together. Ready? Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Kevin. Happy birthday to you.
Wow, that's awesome.
It's Kevin's birthday Thursday. Make sure to shout out Kevin on all your social media pages for his birthday. The big 2-0, right? 2-0.
2-0, I wish.
Awesome. Well, hey, I'm glad you got it eventually.
Wow, that took a while. I'm not as good as you are, obviously.
All right. Hey, so let me switch gears just a little bit, though. All right, so let's switch gears into – we just played a fun game. That was awesome. Switch gears. Kevin, have you ever – felt like God has been speaking, kind of like the game. Have you ever felt like God has been speaking to you, but it's been hard for you to understand what he's saying?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I felt like Bertha, what, like, you know, you feel like you lose things in translation. You're like, what is he trying to say to me? I don't understand. Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, exactly. And so that happens a lot, right? And actually, something that's been really cool that we get to share a little bit is Luke, our very own Luke Klemek. Yep, it's been awesome. He actually has felt like God has shared something specific with him, and he's understood, and he's felt the calling, he's understood that calling, and we actually wanted to give him a little bit of a shot to explain that situation to the GSM family that's watching live now. So in a second, we're going to watch a video with Luke on it, sharing what God's been speaking to him about. But before we do that, can we just pray? And then we'll kind of lead that into that time. Awesome. Let me pray for us. God, thank you so much for tonight. Thank you for this opportunity to be together with GSM across the region, across the area. Whoever's watching, we're so thankful that they're joining in with us. God, we just thank you for an opportunity to be together, even separate. We're so thankful to the opportunity that we have to meet and to be across technology and all the different things that were going on. God, we're grateful that we get to meet together. And tonight, we just pray that whatever is said is glorifying and honoring to you, that you would open our hearts, open our ears to what you have to speak to us about today. And tonight, we're so thankful for Luke and for his sharing. We pray that you would give him the words as well. And as we have small groups and everything else that happens tonight, we just pray that your will would be done and that you'd be in the midst of the programming tonight. We're so thankful again for time to have fun, a time to learn, and a time to open our Bibles and get to learn from you and your word as well. So as we do that tonight, we give you glory, we give you praise. It's your name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Cool. Let's shoot it to Luke and let's see what he has to say while you guys also are getting your Bibles, notebooks, and pens ready for the message tonight.
Take care.
See you guys.
Hey, Grable. We just wanted to come to you with a quick update on our family right now. And as some of you know, Sydney and I had our son Elliot recently now, and he's nearing 3 months, which has been incredible. Just in those moments, getting to watch him grow. And but as we've been praying and talking as a family, we've decided that I will stay home full time with Elliot and watch over him, which means that I will no longer have the opportunity to serve as one of the student pastors at Grable. And it's been an incredible experience, and I've loved the opportunity to serve and what Jesus has been doing at Grable, and that's been an exciting thing over the past 5 years now for us with that. And and in this step of faith that we're taking with our family too, as you know, as a church, our push is for the family, and our push is to do whatever Jesus is calling you to do. And this is us taking that action step and doing what it is we feel like Jesus is asking of us right now. And even if it's maybe different than we originally imagined or thought life would look like in those moments. So as an encouragement to all of you, our prayer as a family is to continue, that Grable would continue to do the incredible work that Jesus has been doing, and that this step of faith that we're taking be an encouragement for you to take whatever step Jesus is calling you to do as well, for you and your families. Students, I hope you know how much Sydney and I love each and every one of you, and we're going to continue to pray for all of you, and we're not leaving the area. We're going to be around. So please reach out and talk. We'd love to still connect with you as we did before. But I want you to know that you are in phenomenal hands, and Jesus is not done yet with what he's doing. So from the Klemek, we love all of you, and we hope to see you all soon.
Yeah.
Bye. Hey everyone. So as we've had this chance to go through this Easter season together, we wanted to continue to elaborate and continue to talk about some of the importance of some of the things we just got to experience. And with that, we want to talk about and start this brand new series called Jesus Is. And we want to talk about, who is Jesus? What did he do? Why does it matter? What does that even mean for all of us? And as we get ready to launch into this, I have a simple question. Have you ever had to ask for forgiveness for something that you did? Whether it be a funny, dumb, embarrassing, whatever the reason being, have you ever had to ask for forgiveness for something? I know when I think back to when I was young, growing up with siblings, one moment that I vividly remember having to ask for forgiveness for was a moment, and maybe you felt like me before, where siblings can get on your nerves a little bit, and maybe even especially right now, as we're all home together more. But I just remember this moment between me and my sisters, and just not getting along, and them just driving me nuts. And I remember tying a rope to their door handle to their bedroom when they went in, and tying it across the hallway to another door so that they couldn't get out, and then going to the basement just to enjoy some peace and quiet before my parents came home and killed me for it. But I remember having to, you know, tell my parents why I did that and how dumb of an idea it was, and having to ask for forgiveness, not only from my parents, but from my sisters, and walk through that process. You know, like, I think all of us have done something dumb at some point in our lives, or at least have done something that we need to ask for forgiveness for. So here's a question for us. Do you think it's easier to ask for forgiveness, or is it easier to forgive someone? I think it's a little bit of a weighted question for all of us. And I think that all of us have been on both sides of that coin. Easier to ask for forgiveness or to actually forgive? And do we know what forgiveness means? What does it mean to actually forgive someone when they've done something wrong to us? Something that didn't set right? I think all of us, yeah, have had that experience. And as we dive into this further, I want us to start thinking about that and about forgiveness as we start to talk about who Jesus is. So who is Jesus? Who, if you had to describe in your own words, and I'd encourage you, if you had pen and paper, to pause for a moment and write, who is Jesus to you? Like, when you think of who is Jesus, what comes to mind? And if you had to ask your friends, if you had to ask people around you, who is Jesus? Who do other people say that he is? How do they describe him? What are the words that people use? What comes to mind to you when you think, this is who Jesus is? It's funny because we're not the first people to ask that question. And we're certainly not the first people to maybe even have a misunderstanding of what that means. And if you have a Bible with you, I want to encourage you to open up to Matthew 16. So we're going to be in Matthew chapter 16, and we're going to be in verses 13 through 16, where this same question was posed. And this is what it says. When Jesus came to the region of Caesarea and Philippi, he asked his disciples, "Who do people say the Son of Man is?" And they replied, "Some say John the Baptist, others say Elijah, and still others Jeremiah or one of the other prophets. But who do you say I am? But what about you?" And Simon Peter answered, "You are the Christ, the Son of the living God." Son of the living God. I think it's crazy that we can all have these different understandings and interpretations of who Jesus is. And in fact, so many people thought that Jesus might have been John the Baptist or Jeremiah or any of these different prophets, Elijah. And people start to wonder, like, who is Jesus? Why does he matter? And isn't it funny that his disciples, the people who actually spent time with him, the people who got to know him, who dug into who he is, had the understanding and the nerve to say, "You are the Christ, the Son of the living God." And that's who Jesus is, isn't it? And as we began to talk about this idea of forgiveness and who is Jesus and being the Son of God, the reality is that only God can forgive sin. And sin, it's this thing, it's this missing of the mark. It's when we mess up, it's when we do something wrong against God, when we go against what God wants for us and against his plan in our lives. And only God can forgive us of our sins. And if only God can forgive sins, what does that mean for us when we talk about Jesus and who Jesus really is? And as we dive into that, I wanna look at another passage in Mark chapter 2. So hopefully you still have your Bible with you and open. If not, I'd encourage you to grab it. And we're going to look at another story in Mark chapter 2 where there's this moment that Jesus has with people. And you know what? Let's just go ahead and dive in to that together. A few days later, when Jesus again entered Capernaum, the people heard that he had come home. So many gathered that there was no room left, not even outside the door, and he preached the word to them. Some men came bringing to him a paralytic, carried by four of them. Since they could not get him to Jesus because of the crowd, they made an opening in the roof above Jesus, and after digging through it, they lowered the mat the paralyzed man was living on. When Jesus saw their faith, he said to the paralytic, "Son, your sins are forgiven." Now some teachers of the law sitting there thinking to themselves, "Why does this fellow talk like that? He's blaspheming. Who can forgive sins but God alone?" Immediately, Jesus in his spirit knew what they were thinking in their hearts, and he said to them, "Why are you thinking these things? Which is easier to say to the paralytic, 'Your sins are forgiven,' or to say, 'Get up, take your mat and walk'? But that you may know that the Son of Man has authority on earth to forgive sins," he said to the paralytic, "I tell you, get up, take your mat, go home." And he got up, he took his mat, and he walked out in full view of all of them. This amazed everyone, and they praised God, saying, "We have never seen anything like this." It's such an incredible story. I think one of the first things that comes to mind that pops out to me is how crazy awesome are these friends of this man. How incredible is it that he had friends that were willing to take him to the extreme, to do anything necessary to get him to the foot of Jesus, to bring him in front of Jesus. They couldn't get through the crowd. They couldn't get through what they might have seen as the normal routes, the easy routes, the routes we should go. Instead, they found an alternative way, and they dug through a roof to get to Jesus. I think that's incredible. And how often is it that you and I come to Jesus with our needs? I think it's something that all of us do quite often, and which makes complete sense. But what happens in the story is what makes it so incredible. See, Jesus doesn't see things the way that we see things. You and I have an understanding of how things should be and how they should go. And we have this feeling of what we think our needs are. But Jesus sees a bigger picture. He sees what actually matters in life, and he addresses it. as soon as this paralyzed man comes in, Jesus doesn't instantly heal his lameness, which maybe is where we are in life right now, is that there's something about us, a lameness about us that we want fixed. And Jesus looks at him and says, son, your sins are forgiven. He says, your sin is forgiven. This bigger picture. See, oftentimes you and I, we miss out on opportunities because we don't understand the power of what we're missing. Jesus does. Only God can forgive sins. And this is just an example of who Jesus is and what he does for us. And it's incredible to me that people had more trouble with Jesus forgiving sins. It came as an astonishment. It was confusing to them. It was frustrating and angering to the teachers of the law that he'd forgive sins. And they were more amazed with a physical healing and what he does. And how often is it that we miss out on what's actually happening, the power of what Jesus is doing? I think something that all of us need to know, and if this is all we get from tonight, then I think it's worth it, is that in Jesus, everyone is welcomed just as they are, but nobody stays the same. In Jesus, we're all welcome just as we are, and we come as we are, but we don't stay the same. Something incredible happens when we have a true encounter with Jesus in our lives. So as we get ready to break and head into small groups and have a conversation together, and I hope that all of you have the chance to meet in your small groups with leaders who love you dearly and they care about you and they're continuing to pray for you in moments like this where maybe we do feel confused and we feel like there's something missing, something maybe we need to get off our chest. Is who is Jesus to us? Who is he and what is he doing? Because I think Jesus wants something very special from all of us. He wants it for us. And I don't think he's done using this youth group yet. I think he has plans, and I think it's incredible seeing what happened in this moment that Jesus was willing to forgive sins of someone who came in with a smaller ask. What are we asking for as a student ministry? What do we want to see Jesus do in our community, in our lives? Because as of right now, we're getting close to ramping up for summer, and it's such an incredible time for us to start investing more into the people we care about and love. And who is it that Jesus is putting on our hearts that we need to be reaching out to and connecting with? Because if we truly believe that Jesus is God and that he's the one who forgives sin, then I think we need to do something about it. We've talked about action steps and that our faith is actually an action. It's something that we need to be doing. It's active, it's present. What does that look for us right now? And what are we going to do about it? I love all of you so much, and I'll always be praying for you. And I hope that you know that Grable Student Ministry is a place for you to be loved, belong, have purpose.
Awesome, Luke. That was so good. Thank you for that challenge. And I know I was challenged, and I'm hoping you are sitting at home as well. You're challenged because, Kevin, I'm taking two things from this. One, Luke was kind of asking, what is God teaching you right now? Like, what is he teaching you? What is he telling you to do? But two, maybe the more important one even for me right now is, what are you going to do about it?
Yeah, and I love that step, because oftentimes we can hear what God's saying, maybe through other people, through his word, maybe he speaks to us. But taking that action step of getting over your fear, your anxiety, your worry to actually do what God's calling you to do can be the challenging part. So I love that action step for tonight is, hey, as GSM, what are we going to do about the things God is calling us to do?
Absolutely. It's a challenge. You can't just sit and stay where you're at, but you guys calling us to do something, to act and to be challenged. And so hopefully you're able to take that challenge where you're at home as well. Hey, we have challenges here at GSM. We've been doing this thing, the weekly challenge, where we're trying to get you guys involved and connected and sending in some submissions. This past week was really cool. It was a unique one because we added some unique features. Kev, what was our last week's challenge for the week?
Yeah, we wanted to get the family involved. And so we challenged you guys to do a video with your family, whether that was some goofy thing that you did out in the backyard or it was a dance that you did. Whatever it was, we wanted you to get your family involved. And so we have some videos that we want you to check out right now.
Up at night. I could just go on and on. I'm good at a lot of things, really.